Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Hens All Access's coverage of University of Delaware baseball alongside Matt Wolfson. I am Kyle Coulter. Thank you so much for joining us on this very special occasion. Not only is it the critical CAA rubber match between the UNCW Seahawks and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens, today is also the day that we rededicate this beautiful, newly renovated stadium to the man who coached more than three decades in it, Mr. Bob Hanna. And now, Matt, I know Coach Hanna was a little before our time, so why don't you refresh mine and yours memory of some accolades of this legendary coach.
Well, Coach Hanna has had such an illustrious career here at the University of Delaware. He was originally a phys ed teacher at UD and obviously became the coach for 35 seasons. 1,053 wins, that is 51st all-time in NCAA baseball. He is 21st in winning percentage, 11 NCAA regional appearances, and a College World Series to his name. Seven-time Conference of the Year winner, a Coach of the Year in conference, and just an unbelievable career for such a great coach.
We will talk more about him as the game goes on, but right now we're going to send it to public address announcer Scott Selheimer to kick off today's festivities.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Bob Hanna Stadium as we proudly present CAA Division I Baseball featuring the UNCW Seahawks and your University of Delaware Fighting Blue Hens. Time, we ask that you please direct your attention to home plate as we welcome University of Delaware Director of Athletics Eric Ziadi to begin the program for today's special Bob Hanna Stadium rededication.
Good afternoon. My name is Eric Ziadi, and it's my privilege to serve as the athletic director here at the University of Delaware. It's my pleasure to welcome all of you here today to celebrate the dedication of the new Bob Hanna Stadium. I want to personally thank all of our special guests for joining us here today, honoring not only a special coach, but a special person. I want to thank and welcome the almost 100 former baseball players here back to campus, the many generous donors and friends of our program, the parents of our current student athletes, and most of all, I want to welcome back Coach Bob Hanna and his wife, June. Today marks another milestone for our department and for our university in terms of significant improvements to our athletic facilities. Beginning in September, we've now witnessed the opening of the new Carpenter Recreation Center, the transformation of the Delaware Fieldhouse into a first-class indoor practice facility, the resurfacing of our practice soccer fields and outdoor track, and the latest plans for our renovated soccer and track venue to be renamed the Stuart and Suzanne Grant Stadium. Today, we celebrate the dedication of the new Hanna Baseball Stadium that will prove to be one of the premier baseball facilities in the Mid-Atlantic region. A project of this magnitude does not happen without contributions from many different groups, and I'd like to thank some of them now. First, I'd like to thank our president, Pat Harker, for his support of this project, as well as his leadership in supporting all of our facility improvements over the past 18 months. I'd like to thank Alan Brangman and his staff in university facilities for their continued support, and I'd like to single out Tom Hudson, who served as the project manager for the Hanna Stadium project, and who together with our dedicated athletic grounds crew has worked tirelessly to see this project through to completion despite the winter weather that we recently had. I'd like to acknowledge Tim Ford and our development staff for their hard work in implementing an outreach campaign that has made this project a reality. And I'd like to especially acknowledge and thank the person that leads all of our facility projects, planning, and improvements, our Senior Associate Athletic Director, Joe Shirley. But despite all the good intentions, a project such as this simply doesn't happen without the financial support of our generous donors. There are two in particular that I'd like to acknowledge now. First, our lead donor, the Appleby family, for naming the new right field scoreboard in memory of Richard M. Appleby. And second, our group of almost 100 former baseball student athletes who have contributed financially to this stadium project. In fact, a remarkable seven decades of Delaware baseball are represented here with us today. The legacy of Bob Hanna goes far beyond wins and losses, far beyond championships or playoff appearances, and far beyond batting average or ERAs. The legacy of Coach Bob Hanna is the incredible impact that he had on the lives of his student athletes and the memories that live in each of them as they've gone on to impact society in their own individual way. To add some further insight illustrating that legacy, please welcome our current head baseball coach, Jim Sherman.
Thanks, Eric. Hey, Coach Hannah, we finally got there. Remember that saying? We just can't get there? Well, we got there today. I appreciate Eric. He's a great leader. He's done a great job in the short 2 years that he's been our athletic director. Joe Shirley, the vision that Joe has and the idea of how to run facilities is second to none. Tim Ford, Phil Tribble, for all their hard work from the development office, endless hours reaching out to our alumni. Ellen Reed, for organizing the tent, the food, for all of her help. And then Martha Mitchell. Martha, you here? Thank you. Martha secured that big contribution from the Appleby family that really got this thing rolling. This made a difference, and once that started to happen, we had all of our alumni jumping on board. You know, this accumulates over 100 years of Delaware baseball. It kind of started in the 20s and the 30s and 40s and the 50s, which kind of built the foundation. As we got into the 60s, they started to play that big league schedule of 20 plus games. We moved to the mid 70s, and then now they really play what we call the big schedule in college baseball, 50 plus games. The 70 World Series team, the one and only World Series team here at Delaware, you guys made this day possible. The 79 team, who we argue with the 70 World Series team, who we thought was the best team. All through the decades of the 80s, the 90s, into the 2000s, all those regional teams, you made this day possible. To the mother of University of Delaware baseball, June Hannah, all those bags of lunches. Those two sandwiches, that apple, that little mint in the brown bag. June Hannah put many and many hours in. She was our mom away from home. And what a great job she did. Thanks, June. To all the assistant coaches, for all the endless hours of BP, hitting fungos, recruiting, to all of you who are here in the stands, on the field, this day is because of you. And then obviously the man of the hour, the best man I've ever dealt with on a baseball field, on and off the baseball field. There's not even a second guy I've ever dealt with. The classiest act of a man on the field and off the field I've ever seen. It's not a phony act. He was our father, he was our grandfather. At times, many of us, we thought he was actually God. It was amazing. But he was the reason today has happened. Coach Hannah, congratulations. Enjoy this day, and I'm honored to be the coach had followed right behind you. Thanks, Coach.
Thanks, Coach. As I mentioned earlier, one of the features of this project that makes it so special is the directive involvement of almost 100 former baseball student athletes. I'd like to now introduce two of them that played an instrumental role in designing and implementing an outreach campaign that resulted in the facility you see today. David Yates, class of 1970 and recent inductee into the Delaware Athletics Hall of Fame, and Mickey DeMattis, class of 1978, are two former baseball standouts who not only are donors to the Hannah Stadium Project, but have been leaders of a volunteer fundraising campaign specifically aimed at involving and engaging former Blue Hen baseball players. Please join me and give David and Mickey a hand. I'd now like to have Coach Hannah join me up here for a special presentation. Coach Hannah, for all that you've done and for all that you have meant to the University of Delaware and the Delaware baseball program, I'd like to show to you now the final feature of the Hannah Stadium renovation. This new Boston plaque will be permanently displayed outside of Bob Hannah Stadium as a lasting tribute and a sign of thanks for all that you have done for our university and our baseball program. We'd also like for you to have this framed replica plaque from the bust to take home with you today. Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Bob Hannah.
Wow, what a turnout. An outstanding crowd. I really forgot what I was going to say. That's not unusual when you get to be my age. As a matter of fact, my wife sent me out the other day and said, hey, look, while you're running some errands, pick up a butterscotch sundae. And she said, make sure you write it down because I know how forgetful you are. So when I came back, I handed her a roast beef sandwich. And she said, I knew you should have written it down. I asked you for mayonnaise, not mustard. So that's where we are in terms of trying to remember what we're doing. I really appreciate this day and appreciate particularly all the former players that have shown up to say hello and to be a part of this ceremony. You know, the first game in the history of Delaware baseball was played more than 130 years ago. And contrary to public opinion, I was not there to see that ball game. But I was here for the first game played on this site in March 1966. The opponent was Yale. It was a horribly cold and blustery day. And I remember it well because the Yale coach came to the ballpark in his uniform with a wool knit cap pulled down over his ears and his top coat over top of his uniform. We did win that ball game on the first game played on this site. And it so happens that the first game played on this new field by this current crop, the 2014 ball club, they played Northeastern and won a 1-0 ball game in extra innings. We're here today really to say hello to all the people who have supported this program and to put our final stamp of approval on this project. Most importantly, I think we gather here to acknowledge those who are responsible and made a major contribution toward bringing this project to fruition. And I'd like to say thank you to University President Harker and the administration, and especially to Athletic Director Eric Ciedi and his staff, and the Athletic Development Office, remarkable effort by Tim Ford and Phil Tribble and all of that gang to make this possible. And of course, to former players and coaches who were a part of this. You've already met Dave Yates and Mickey DeMattis, who spent endless hours on the phone encouraging guys to step up and be a part of this project. And of course, we want to say thank you to multiple long-standing friends and and supporters of this program who also were willing to stand up and contribute to what has happened here. We thank you for being here today, and we hope that you'll enjoy this day, enjoy the ball game. Hopefully you'll come back for other ball games along the way, and go Hens.
Thank you all once again for joining us today. I'd like to end today's ceremony by inviting Coach Hannah to come out to the mound and throw today's ceremonial first pitch.
A little closer.